I'm here with pastry chef and owner Matt Lewis. Matt, I see root beer. What are you doing with it?
We're gonna make some root beer bun cake today. And I have to tell you, it's like one of my favorite things. It's perfect for summer, perfect actually for any party you're going to.
So what made you think of putting root beer in a cake?
You know, it's funny. We actually have this like obsession, both my business partner and I, of root beer floats. So it's like, why not take a root beer float and turn it into a cake? We're all about American desserts at Baked, and this is like the ultimate American dessert turned into a cake. So you're gonna take a bundt pan, and one of the big secrets we always say is, there's, you know, everybody used to butter and flour the pan and then you knock it out. The problem with that is the flour kind of gets stuck in here.
In the crevices.
You get stuck in the crevices and the crown of your cake is like covered with little chunks of flour. It's kind of gross.
Right, looks gross.
So we'll go ahead and use Pam or any type of vegetable spray you want.
So a good tip is that you want to use a vegetable spray so that you can get all the crevices of your pan.
This is easier, faster, and less messy too. All right, so the first thing you want to do is just get a pot overheat. You could even do this on an induction stove like we're doing right now. You're gonna take a cocoa powder. We use a really, really dark cocoa powder. I like Valrhona.
Okay, so what makes the cocoa powder Dutch? I don't even know what that is.
The Dutch process, all that means is it's put through like a leavener process. It is a chemical process and it does make it a little darker. I think it gives it a nice chocolate flavor and it really brings it out. It's really robust. Then we're gonna put in some root beer. Do not use a diet root beer. If you're making a cake, why would you use diet? One of our big tricks is we like to use a lot of liquor when we bake. So this is a root beer schnapps. The root beer schnapps really intensifies the flavor of the root beer bun. You don't want to use too much. And if you're making this for a kid's birthday party, maybe you could skip this part. I'm gonna just throw in a little bit of butter as well.
Is that room temperature butter?
This doesn't matter because we're just gonna boil this over the top. Good question though. A lot of times when you're making a cake, you do want a room temperature butter. This is like a hearty bundt cake. There's a lot more mistakes you can make on this and it won't mess up. And we're bringing this over medium heat just until it's melted. All the butter will be out, all the cocoa will be completely gone at this point.
It'll be one consistent texture.
And remember, we're not boiling this. Now, while I'm going and finishing this part, I'm gonna have you put the flour and salt in this bowl, and then just drizzle over the top the baking soda. If you really want a light texture, which you're going for sometimes, you'll sift the ingredients. We're not worried about the texture of this cake. We want it to be dense and kind of full.
So if you want a dense texture, you don't need to sift your flour when you put it in your mixture.
Go ahead and use the whisk though, just to kind of whisk it up so the baking soda is incorporated into the flour. Mm-hmm. Now we're gonna go ahead and put the two different types of sugar in here. So we've got the regular sugar.
So this is white and this is brown.
Anything with like a little extra molasses makes me just really, really happy. All right, so we're gonna put two eggs into this mixture and you're just gonna really gently mix those in. Put the flour in here and then if you could show everybody a really great technique for folding. Folding means that you're not beating air into the actual mix. You're actually just gently putting the flour in. One of my great tips, and I tell people this all the time, especially for brownies and cakes, is when you're adding flour and folding it in, a way to stop yourself from putting too much in is you want a little trace of the flour on the top.
Okay.
Absolutely. It's like kind of a safety measure.
This is, you know, really great for the home cook because they can make it at home all in, you know, maybe one bowl and one burner.
Now this root beer flavor, just so you know, if you bake it the day before, the root beer flavor intensifies the next day. That's pretty much true with, you know, anytime you're using a chocolate dessert and adding either like a liqueur or an extract. Also, don't put this thing in the refrigerator because if you're using like a lot of stuff in your refrigerator, like leftover Chinese food, chocolate tends to absorb the flavor.
Of course, and the aroma. You want that aroma in
your cake. We're going for the root beer bun cake, not the Chinese food bun cake.
That's true. So are we ready to bake yet?
I think so. Let's put it into the bun. We're gonna get every bit of that batter. Mm-hmm. We always, always knock our cake pans. You wanna get any air bubbles out, and we're gonna go ahead and put this in the oven. And one of the things you wanna do is you wanna put this in the oven, rotate it halfway through, and check it about every half hour. If you want, get a big, big, like thin knife, really sharp, stick it right in the middle of the bundt cake in about two or three places to make sure there's no cake coming out on it. If it comes out clean, it's done.
Right, and so why are you rotating in the oven? Do you want it to cook evenly? You want to get a golden brown color?
You want it to cook evenly, but also there's a lot of hot spots in people's ovens. So it might be 25 degrees over here and 25 negative degrees over here.
Owner Renato Pollifito. Renato, it's icing time.
You have some melted chocolate here. You have some cocoa powder here. Remember, you always want to use a good quality chocolate whenever you have chocolate in a recipe, obviously.
Of course.
Got some confectioner's sugar, so a little bit of salt, and some room temperature butter there. You want the butter to be room temperature because when you mix this, it comes together really fast.
It incorporates much better when the butter is room temperature.
So exactly.
It's a good tip for the
whole. Otherwise, you're going to have a clumpy frosting.
Maker.
Ugh, who needs
no
that?
No clumpy frosting.
No, no. Let's get that confectioner sugar and salt.
All in here.
Then your butter, add your cocoa powder, and add your chocolate, and then you add the root beer. So now you want to add about a quarter cup, but I like to add actually a little bit more. Now what I'm going to do is we're going to pulse. Let it run. And that's it, and then we just ice the cake. It's as easy as that. You don't want to start with a hot cake. Simply
then the
because
icing,
it'll just drip
it'll
down.
Just melt
it'll,
on it, melt especially off, with the butter.
And it'll look terrible. And I like it to kind of just go over the edges. If it's a little too loose for your liking, pop it in the fridge for a few minutes and it'll set right up. Well, if you don't have a cake stand, you could do lots of things. You could put it on a large platter and just turn as you go. If you don't have an offset spatula, I use a knife. You know, the whole goal here is to have it look a little homespun, have it look
of
a little
course.
Homemade. I think that makes it look nicer.
And there you have it, the
delicious.
Root beer bundt.
Ta-da!
So Renato, you thought I was gonna leave here without eating, but I'm not.
Oh, well, no, why would
so
you?
So you gotta cut me a slice.
Of course, of course. Well, the easiest thing to do, you always wanna eat a cake at room temperature. If it's too cold, let it get to room temperature, but if it is too cold and you can't wait, I would heat up the knife a little, put it in some hot water.
Moist, chocolatey, you get that root beer flavor. It is really phenomenal.
Delicious,
and it's kind of airy as well.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for having us.
Thank you.